Our next speaker is Lauren Anderson. Lauren served as CEO of the Neighborhood Housing Services of New Orleans from 1993 to 2013. She recently launched her business, Lauren C. Anderson Coaching and Consulting Services, to build upon her extensive experience in management, organizational development, and training as a professional coach. Lauren goes beyond the simple desire for change to unearth what motivates adaptation. In her opinion, meaningful change begins with the why, an understanding of the values and needs that become the winds beneath the sails of change. Throughout her career, Lauren has been on innumerable boards and is a founding advisory board member of StayLocal. Please welcome Lauren.
So this is StayLocal. It feels like I'm coming back home doing something with StayLocal. I'm not even going to try to say how long ago it was that we were neighbors on Perrette Street. Close. Okay. So this is my avatar these days. When I saw this or heard this quote, it just like really resonated with me. Because change is something that I've come to embrace for myself and come to think about a lot as it relates to me and as it relates to how I support the work of other people. So, I just love this, and I'm just like, I'm starting this. So, you know, they say there's one constant, you know? You're gonna death and taxes. But, you know, there's another constant, and that's change. You know, nothing stays the same. I think there's a song like that. And so what I really want to focus on is how we react to change, but mostly how we create sustainable change in our lives. I bet if I were to take a poll, the majority of folks here would be thinking about or wanting to create some kind of change in their life or business, right? No hands. And, you know, I know this from my own life. For 20 years, I was the CEO of Neighborhood Housing Services, a nonprofit whose mission was revitalizing neighborhoods primarily through homeownership and redevelopment. So back in 93, we moved on to Perrette Street, and a core part of our mission was the revitalization of Perrette Street. Talk about change, right? Look at it now. And so, you know, we laid the foundation with the very first Perrette Street Festival back in 1993. We bought and renovated at least 6 commercial properties in the neighborhood. And so when Katrina came and there was a new wave of energy, it was the work that our nonprofit did that kind of laid the foundation for folks like Michelle to come into the neighborhood. And I still pinch myself when I'm on Perrette Street because it's like, oh my goodness, you know? As much as I wanted it, I never believed that it would be what it is today. So 20 years into my tenure as the CEO of NHS, I'm beginning to feel like, you know, it's time. It's time for change. But I didn't know what, I didn't have a plan. It's like, oh, I don't know what to do. And then God showed me he has a sense of humor. God came along and gave me a good, swift kick in the butt in the form of our family deciding that my mother, who was 80-something with dementia, couldn't live alone anymore. And so I was given change because I decided that there was no way when I moved her from Connecticut to New Orleans to live with me that I could continue to be a nonprofit CEO and take care of her and do either well, let alone maintain my own sanity. So God kicked me off that cliff without a parachute, and I've been recreating my life ever since. So I've learned some lessons for myself that I want to just share with you about how do we deal with change? So, again, I'm not going to ask you to raise your hands. But I know if some of you are like me, in the middle of the night, in those wee hours, you get those questions and those thoughts that start turning in your head. And it's like that record needle that's stuck. And it's like, how do I, what do I? If you're managing a business, it may be those issues that you're confronting at work that you know aren't quite working right and aren't working for you. And it's like, what do I do? What do I do? And it's the same question over and over again. So this is where I've learned how to pick up that needle and change the conversation. So think about some questions that you may have in your life. How do I make that change? And here are some things that I know that helped me get out of that loop. First, and this sounds a little bit contradictory, but do whole body listening. Don't just have that conversation in your head, but our whole body has a whole lot to tell us. If I put my hand on my stomach right now, there's a flutter. And I know what that flutter is. It's like that beating wings of the butterfly. It's that energy that comes from being up here. But it's telling me something. And so if we don't just listen to ourselves with our head, but with our heart and with our whole body, there's lessons to be learned. But the other aspect is find a trusted partner or partners. We all have friends. We all have business associates. But who do you know with whom you can have a fierce conversation? Not a make nice conversation, not a feel good conversation, but a conversation where you can go to this person and say, this is what's really important to me. Tell me what I'm missing. Have that fierce conversation where you ask and answer tough questions. One of the things I really believe in are creating peer groups. I'm in a couple of peer groups right now. And it's a safe place where I can go and talk about what matters to me most and know that I'm going to give and get honest feedback that pushes my needle. And finally, we talk about change, we say we're going to change, and we may take that one step forward, and then we may take that two step back. What I found has made the difference for me is having an accountability coach. It's, again, that trusted partner, that peer group, who when you say, like I did a year or so ago, I don't want to just work anymore. I think there's something creative in me that needs to come out. I don't have time to do it. How am I going to do it? And I kept working with my peer support who held me accountable to do what I said I was going to do for myself. Left to our own devices, the here and now, the urgent, always gets in the way of what's important. Find that trusted partner or those peer group who will hold you accountable to do the things that you say you want to do for yourself that are important to you. So, that's what I got.
Thank you, Lauren. I love the butterfly imagery throughout it. I thought it was much more appropriate than all the sharks I put on everything. So, good thought for next year.